Hi, this is David with Flex Innovations out here at the beautiful Venice Field today to give you guys an overview of our new Aura Professional series of a gyro-based product. You can see here for size comparison, we have the original Aura 8, then we have an Aura 12 Professional and an Aura 8 Professional. So basically, first thing you might notice when you're looking at this is it has a beautiful CNC metal case, anodized and so forth. It really protects the electronics. It acts as a heat sink and also just makes it a beautiful high-end product. You'll see you have mounting lugs, which this one has the grommets installed, which are included, and it allows you to actually bolt your gyro into your airplane. And that also allows a Velcro strap to come around if you need additional security there. Another thing you might notice early on is you have these two really big fat pipe wires. Those are your battery inputs. We offer dual battery inputs, and the Aura Professional basically becomes your power supply for your aircraft on board. So your batteries come in, example 2S LiPos and so forth, come in through the two connectors and go into the Aura. On the face of the Aura, there's a switch port, and it's just a very fine wired port that doesn't really handle the current. It just tells the Aura to turn on and off. So you have a switch that can be mounted in your aircraft there to change your power. Basically, with the power system as well, you have a window over here that has some LED lights in it. There's a pair of white lights. If your batteries are plugged in, the power's on, and your batteries are near equal voltage, you'll see the two white lights indicating batteries present. There's also two red LEDs in the window. And those are going to kind of give you a little quick view of your battery status. They're programmable by the Aura Config tool. And basically, you could program it, for instance, to instantaneously look at the voltage. If the voltage is, say, programmed 7.6 volts, then you're going to get maybe a flashing red LED on that battery. And if the voltage, say, was below 7.2 volts, you can program it to make the LED go solid red as a stronger warning. You can glance at it when you power it up and just give a quick check to make sure your batteries are in a good condition when you take off and when you land. You'll also see down along the bottom edge, in the case of Aura 12, we have 12 servo ports. In the case of Aura 8, we have 8 servo ports. And those allow you, obviously, to plug in servos, primarily your flight controls and high-powered, you know, elevator, rudder, all that type of thing are going to plug into there. Next, you're going to see the A and the B port. Those are primarily used as inputs, also can be used as outputs in some cases, but they communicate with your receiver, for example, and you can input almost any digital format you might see in the market. You know, you can do S-Bus, Jetty, SRXL, Gropner, you know, Spectrum, almost any brand that has a digital data stream, we're going to accept that and allow you to do it. Now, what's a little new with the Aura Pro is we have the A and the B port in this form factor, and you can do what we call diversity. So for example, if you have a Futaba, which is the first one we're supporting, you can have two Futaba receivers, plug in each of the receivers, and one into A, one into B, and then you can mount, say, the A in the front of the airplane, the B in the back of the airplane if you have a large aircraft, and if either one of the receivers is providing a good signal, the Aura is going to use that signal to command your airplane. So that gives you redundancy and backup, and you know, in certain brands it's harder to get diversity, and that's why we start with Futaba to allow you to use two receivers. If you're familiar with Aura, you know we have certain features like maybe a quick trim that allows you to transfer your trim into the Aura to optimize the flight controls. And in the past, you had to use bind plugs and stuff like that or a PC to get it to work, but now we have buttons provided and you can just press the button, boot it up, and do things like quick trim. Probably also have like a quick gyro check to amplify the gyro sensor testing and so forth. So that gives you a very good capability to do some extra features without needing any other tools or gadgets to do it. You might also notice we have a little port on the front, USB labeled, and that is a micro USB connector. And that allows you to connect this to your PC. Basically, we have the Aura Config tool, which is a free download, and that is going to be, you know, the primary way to do the major programming and everything of the Aura using the Aura Config tool. So The last feature I want to just show you on the overview is we have a little port on the end there. And it's the one right here on the left. And we call that the remote sensor port. And here you see what plugs into it. And we have a little box here, which plugs right in there. And that little guy is actually a gyro sensor that is very hardened against noise. So in some of the jet aircraft, you'll get certain noise coming from the engine, which can really resonate with the gyro chip or cause the gyro chip to get a little bit confused or antsy. And especially if you have like a thrust vectoring jet, you have very high gains, you may notice a little bit of bumping in the controls and stuff. So we solve that problem. This is a sensor. It's embedded in layers of wood and other materials to knock that noise down while not limiting your access to the actual control box. But all the hardening is right on the sensor itself. And then in another video we can explain some of the different options of using the sensor, but a very good option to have on your larger jet aircraft. Thanks for listening to the overview, and look for us in other videos.